Hello friends, I am Yash Patel and welcome back to my channel Django World. So in last video, we have seen how we can render data in our HTML page, and in today's video, we are going to see that how we can render a data relevant to particular block in block detail page. So for that, we need to understand a concept of a slug. So what does slug mean? Slug means a clean URL that refers to a particular page. So if I click to read more, then it should render the data only relevant to this particular block, not other else. So if I will click on another read more, then it will show me same data, which we don't want. So for that, we need slug. And to do that, we will need to update our models. So let's jump to VS Code and do that. So here, I will go to my models.py and we will add slug field in blog model. Okay, so here I will write slug. Sorry, is equals to, let me disable my copilot. So let me zoom also. Okay, after writing slug, we will write models dot care field. And here we will give max length is equals to 1000, null equals to true, and blank is equals to true. Okay, so after doing this, we need our model to create slug by its own. So here we will write one method as save. So def save. This method takes default argument self and args and quarks. Okay. And here we will define our slug method for creating this slug. So if not self dot slug, then create this slug. So self dot slug equals to, we have one method function known as slugify. So slugify, so to use this method we need to import that first. So here we will import from Django dot template dot default filters import slugify. Okay, now we will be able to use this function. So here I want to create URL according to my title name, then our posted date, to make this URL more unique, because if any other person post the blog, any different user post this blog with same title, then unfortunately we will face error and the link will be similar. So here we, to make it unique, we are going to create slug according to name and post date. Okay, so here we will give variable self dot name, and here we will use concatenation method to concatenate our strings. Okay, so I will replace this with dash because slug don't have any space. If you will come in TechCrunch and see, then every space has been replaced by hyphen. Okay, you can see that it will be bad practice to put space between URLs, so we are not going to do this. So self dot post date. So date here is not in string form, so we need to wrap this field in string. So str and paste that in that parenthesis. Okay, now we have created this slug And finally, we will return this. So return space super dot save. Here we will give our quarks and args. So copy this and paste in save method. Now we are fine to migrate. So open your terminal. I will stop my server. I will clear the terminal and I will run make migration command. So python manage.py make migrations. Hit enter. You can see our slug field is added. Now here I will migrate these changes. So python manage.py migrate. Now we have migrated our database. So I will run server and I will come over here and refresh. We are not facing any error. So here I will go to admin panel, and if I will go in R programming, then you can see we have the slug field over here. So let me hit save only. I think it should create slug. You can see it has been created automatically. So when we enter a new entry, we will not add any data in this field because it is going to create automatic with the help of this function. So you can see we have title and the posted date. So let's repeat the same process to other two entries. Save, save. Now we have slug added. So let me go to the main website, and if I will click on this, then it should render the data. So to do that, we need to go to views.py. So first thing, we need to changes, like here I will give slug. Okay, I'll give slug over here. Then I will update my URL. If anyone goes block underscore detail and then slash, it should accept the string. This string. Okay, so here we are passing string. So str colon the variable name which we passed over here. So it will be slug. Save this and come to views.py back, and here we will bring blog equals to blog the model name dot objects dot get. Here get method is to get detail about particular field. So we need to get detail for the slug field. So here we will give slug equals to the variable which is passed over here. So slug. Okay, to make it more clear, to remove the confusions for beginners, I will write slug underscore URL, and I will change this here also, and I will change this to urls.py file. Now I think it should be clear. Now after doing that, I will make context variable and create dictionary and pass this block and pass this context to the render function. Now we should be fine. So after doing this, we need to go to our home blog underscore home page, because our read more button is on blog home page, right? So here we need to do data dot slug, because all the data in the blogs is stored in this for loop variable, and we can access any field from here. So we have accessed data.log. Okay, data.slug, sorry, not log. Now come to home page and come and refresh over here. Now if I will click on read more, then you can see we are redirected to blog details underscore markdown, after that the posted date. So here I will go to read more and let's render the data. Okay, now we will go to blog detail. Okay, and here we will not do for looping, because we are going to access the data, a single data. We are not accessing multiple data. So here I will just remove this fake title, and I will do blog dot name. Remember, this blog will be coming from here. Okay, the key, not value, key. So blog dot name. Where is that? I will close this home page. Yeah, blog dot name. If I will refresh, then you can see we have got this title. I will go home again. I will go to Python. Then you can see we can get our title dynamically. So same way we are going to do for author. Blog dot author. Come over here, refresh. Okay. Then here we will do same thing. Name, sorry. Blog dot models dot py post underscore date. I will remove all this content, and here I will pass blog dot description. Okay, so save this, come over here and refresh. You can see we have displayed all our content dynamically. I will go home page, do this read R, then you can see we have got content related to R, the title and the posted date. Okay, so this is it for today's video, guys. So in next video we are going to render the blog list, okay, the top 5 blogs in our blog detail page, to show suggestions to the reader. So I will see you in next one.